of object-oriented design and programming, fifth module. This is the second lecture in the series. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the event delegation model. Event delegation model in Java. So before going into the basics fundamentals of the event model, let's look into a small example. So how this event model works. Okay, so this is a sample applet program in which the event is handled. Okay, just run this program. Okay, this is have a button. In this button we have a label, I am Java. So when we click on this button, it generates the Java features. So when I click the Java, I am Java button, yes, I am robust. So Java is robust, as of all of you know about the Java feature. So Java is robust. When I click it, Java is, I am a platform independent. Yes, Java is platform independent, right? Java, I am object oriented. Okay, so this is just an example for the event handling in Java. So in this program, I have created a button and I created a random strings for generating the features. So when I click the button, it randomly picked a feature from the file and generates corresponding feature in a text box. So all this code, don't worry about all these codes. We will look into all this code in the coming sessions. Okay, so event handling. So what is event? So a change in state of an object or source is called event. For example, in our previous example, we have a button. So when we click the button, it happens, an event is happened. The button click. Okay, the state of the button is changed. So change in state of an object or source is called event handling, event. And event handling, it is the mechanisms to control the event and decides what should happen if an event occurs. Okay, in the previous example, when I click the button, a corresponding feature is picked from the in text list and it is displayed in the text box. So that is event handling. So when an event occurs, how it is, we are going to handle the event, which is explained in the event handling mechanism. Okay, for an event, there should be two main components. So event source and the event listener. So event source means, in the previous example, the button is the event source, because the button click event is happened in the button. So the button is the event source. So all event source, there should be an event listener associated with it. Okay, so event listener decides what we have to do when an event is happened. So all the event listeners should register with the event source first, and then an event is happened, that event source notifies the corresponding registered event listeners. Then the event listeners receives the event object and it determines what to do with that event. Okay, in the previous example, when the event listener receives the button click event, it determines I have to select a random feature from the string list and it has to be displayed in a text box. So that is done by the event listeners. So the event listener simply waits. So first the event listener register with the event source and it simply waits until it receives an event. So it simply waits. So if an event happens, it is captured by the event listeners and performs the corresponding operation. Okay. So next we can study in detail about the different components in the event delegation model. So the first component in the event delegation model is the events. So event is an object that describes the state change in a source. So as already discussed, so it's an object that describes the state change in a source. So how the state is changed, like button is clicked, the mouse is moved, mouse event is scrolled. So these are the mouse scroll button is scrolled. So these are the different events. So this can be generated due to an user interacting with the elements in a graphical user interface. So the user's interactions in a graphical user interface may generate an event, like pressing a button. When I press a keyboard, an event is happen pressing a button. So entering a character via a keyboard, so I am trying to enter some character via the keyboard, so that is another event. So selecting an item in a list, so we have a list and we are selecting an item from the list, this is another event. So clicking the mouse, so when we click the mouse, it's an event. So anything which describes the state change in a source, a state is changed from when a button is pressed, it's changed. Definitely there is a state change for the button. Okay. And we can say that every time an user, a user will be there after the interaction of the user and event is generated, we can say it's such like that. So it may also occur not directly caused by the interaction with the user interface. So sometimes, so if we design a timer in our program, and if the timer expires, we have to close some window. So that's also an event. So if a counter exceeds a certain value, we have to do something. That's another event. So if a software or hardware failure occurs, which will also cause some events. So if an operation is complete, for example, if we are copying a file, and if the file operation is closed, then we have to close the window. So event may also happen by other operations also. Okay. And then event sources. So source is an object that generates an event. In the previous example, the button is a source because it generates the event. Because when you click on the button, it generates an event. So button is a source. So this occurs when an internal state of the object changes in some way. Sources may generate more than one type of event. For example, when we consider a mouse. So mouse can generate multiple types of events, like a left button click, right button click, mouse scroll movement, then mouse movement, mouse dragging. So these are the different types of events that can generate by a source. So a single source can generate multiple events. Then all event listeners must register with the source. That's a mandatory thing. All the event registers, all the event listeners register with the source. Then only when a particular event is happened, which is notified to the listener. Then each type of event has its own registration method. So this is an example. So this is general form. So here the type indicates the name of the event, and EL is the reference to that event listener. For example, if we are going to add a key listener, the key listener is adding for handling the keyboard press or on. Okay, so here the key listener is the key is the type. So type of the listener is key listener. Okay, which is mentioned. This is a general syntax. Add, then we have to specify the type of the listener. If it's a keyboard listener, key listener. If it's a text box listener, then we have to text listener. So the type of is specified here. So type of the listener specified here. And EL is just an object. When an event occurs, the all registered listeners are notified and receive a copy of the event. And this is called the multicasting method. So when an event is occurred in a source, so it notifies all the listeners which is registered with that source, which is called the multicasting. Unicasting is also possible in Java. So if an event happened at a source and which is only notified to only a single listener, so that is unicasting. Unicasting is also possible in Java. Then event sources. So event sources, we already discussed this, which is the place where the event is happen. So we already discussed how can we register a listener to the source by using add type listener. So if we want to remove an already registered listener from a source, then we can use this method. So the remove type listener method is used to remove a listener which is already registered to a source. Okay, so in the previous slide we discussed about the add key listener, which is the method which is used to add a keyboard listener. So if you want to remove that keyboard listener, we can use the remove key listener. So here the type specifies the type of the listeners already registered with the source. So if you want to remove already registered listener, we can use the remove type listener method. Okay, then next is event listeners, the third component. So the event source, event, and the event listener. These are the main components in event delegation model. So listener. So listener is an object that is notified when an event occurs. So when an event occurs at a source, then that source notifies the corresponding listeners. There is major two requirements for a listener. The first requirement is it must have been registered with one or more sources to receive notifications about specific type of events. So the listener should be registered with some sources. Second, it must implement the method to receive and process these notifications. Okay, so it should implement a method. When an event is happen, what we are going to perform, which is written in the implementation method, and it is defined in the java.awt.event package. For example, the mouse motion listener is an interface which defines two methods. So we'll look into the details in the upcoming sessions. So for example, here we just discussed about a mouse motion listener, which has already two implementation methods. For the methods is for drag, whether the mouse is dragged or whether the mouse is moved. So any object may receive and process one or more of these events if it provides an implementation of this interface. Okay, so this is about the event delegation model. Let's look into a small event delegation model example by using the keyboard. So this is an example. So this is an example which implements the keyboard listener. So we are implementing the Java applet codes and Java events for handling the Java handling the applet, and it extends the applet package. So as already you know about that, the applet package is used to, applet class is used to implement the applet. So we have to extend the applet class to implement it, and we also implement the key listener, because here I am using the keyboard. For the keyboard movement, I am using the key listener. Okay, so I already told that every listener should register with a source. So this is the method. So in this method, I am going to register my key listener. So my key listener is registered with this object, this corresponding object, and this key listener has three abstract methods. So key press, key release, and the key type. As key listener, we are implementing the key listener, which means key listener is an interface. We have to expand all the methods which is there in the interface, right? So key listener is an interface. In the key listener, we have three methods: key press, key release, and key type. So key press means when a key is pressed, the corresponding action to be performed is determined by the key press method. And key release means when a key is released, which is handled by the key release method. And when we type something, which is handled by the, so here when a key is pressed, I just show a status that key is pressed in the applet window. And when a key is released, I just display key release method. And in the key typed event, so what are the character which I type, which is get, through the getChar method. So getChar method can get the character of the key I have typed and which is displayed in the message. And you know that the paint method is used to draw the window, to display the applet window. So when we run this program, so this is the program. So the applet is executed. So when I press the key, so I am going to press the key yes, so the yes is displayed, and I am going to press A, R, G, U. So all the key press is displayed. So look at here. So this is a status. So now the no key is pressed. So the status is displayed like key is released. So when I press something, so it will show that key is pressed. So now look at the status section. So now the key is pressed, and now key release. So can get the status. So it can use the three abstract methods: key press for. So we have to expand this method. So what are the operations which we have to perform when the key is pressed, and we have to expand this method. What are the operations we have to perform when the key is released, and we have to expand this method, key type method. So when a key is pressed, when this key is pressed, what you have to do? So I have, this is a sample event delegation example. Okay. So what is the advantage of event delegation model? What is its advantage? The event delegation model. The advantage of event delegation model is that the application logic that processes the event is clearly separated from the user interface logic that generates the event. So the user interface is created one area, and when we interact with that user interface, the actions to be performed is defined in another area. So there is a clear separation between the user interface and the action to be performed. So a user interface element is able to delegate the processing of an event to a separate piece of code. So that it is called an event delegation model. Thank you.